So right now we are living in a pretty interesting time in terms of the type of content people are consuming online. And with TikTok, YouTube Shorts, and Instagram Reels, it seems pretty obvious to me that short form vertical video content is just king right now. And honestly, it kind of feels like we're living in Vine version 2 right now. So today, I thought I'd take you guys along and show you how I produce some of this type of content for clients and companies I'm involved with, and show you a little behind the scenes of what goes in to producing a couple reels. Oh, and I'm gonna edit it all on this bad boy. Shout out to Asus for sponsoring this week's video. Let's get into it. All right, so a bunch of friends always play volleyball on the beach every Thursday. So I've decided to come shoot a little reel for River. And something I've realized is the mistake a lot of people make nowadays is when you're shooting a product video or commercial, you know, people don't care about your product. I think that's a very hard thing to realize as a brand. So sell a lifestyle. So I went and bought these glasses. I'm gonna go run around, put them on everyone's face here, get them to pose for a photo. I'm just gonna take it with my phone because it's that simple and easy. I shot something like this a while back with a bunch of River cans, it was flashing, staying pretty centered, worked out pretty well. So now we're gonna do the same sort of concept except with sunglasses. Keep the sunglasses the center in the video and all the different faces flashing. We'll see how it turns out. All right, now we're back in the edit cave. I'm gonna put this little reel together with all the photos. But first, I'm gonna back up all the photos into the cloud because I've got 1 terabyte of storage space in the cloud. Might as well take advantage of that. So then I'm gonna jump back into Premiere, make some magic, line up the sunglasses, and here is the final result.
Bad night.
So for our next shoot, we have come out to Apex. What is it? Apex Glamping? Apex Glamping at Camdebu, Mount Camdebu Reserve. There are pretty much lions, elephant, anything that can just be roaming around, but buddy of mine has set up an epic igloo style cabin here and we're gonna shoot a little raw reel with it. I'm thinking POV, and what I'll do is I will pretend to jump out of the bed, run down this path and jump into the hot tub with everyone else, and they'll probably throw me a cold river on the way. So I'm gonna shoot this whole scene with the GoPro Max on a mouth mount or bite mount, and yeah, we just shot the POV clip the cabin into the hot tub, and now I'm copying the footage across and we're just gonna throw it together in Premiere, and it should be a pretty quick edit right over here. Friend of mine builds these insane cabins out here in the reserve, and we're gonna shoot this evening. I'm gonna go shoot a scene here with the Max and the 270 Pro. We're gonna make it look like one continuous shot. The camera's gonna come in here through the trees, around past the hammock, and then through the side window of the cabin and out, and we're gonna make it loop. So that's the plan. We'll see how well we execute it, but nice to be out in the wild again. You never come home. You can do sport, you could be a team, I could be a lot, you could even be a league. You could find God, you could find me, you could find love, you could do a TV. You can be a four, never born four. We just diamonds on the sea. I can be more, I can be more. Tell me where you wanna be. You walk down the other road. It's the first step you never came home. And I can tell you. Since back when I was 17, I've been lost, but I'm never alone.
got wrapped up at Apex Cabins. We're on the way back to Cape Town, and I am gonna get some editing down the road, put that little 360 clip together, and yeah, edit on the go. We're about to shoot with one of my favorite people to shoot with. We're gonna have some fun with the Max, create some pretty crazy transitions. Kayla is gonna skate up and down here on the prom. We've got Gabe shooting BTS. Yeah, gonna put the Max on the 270 Pro and just go crazy with it. Make Kayla do a couple wardrobe changes. We're shooting for Bacon Active, Bacon Bikinis. And that's the one. Of ecstasy, 'cause it's not written in our destiny. I wanna be if all I've given would throw me sand, the world would know me for who I am. Maybe your soul will see all me. I wanna be I'm sinking 666, I'm going down with the bricks. This ain't no gangster. Another epic shoot with Kayla. I'm gonna jump back into Premiere, do some editing with the Reframe plugin, and make a transition through her legs from one outfit to another, and hopefully make a pretty fun reel out of it for Bacon Active. Let's see what we can do. Okay. So for this next scene, we've come to the beach. I'm gonna shoot a little transition reel with Kayla. We've got her in the Bacon Bikini one piece. I'm gonna shoot all on my phone just to showcase that you can make pretty cool content with just a phone these days. So basically the concept is Kayla's gonna sit down on the beach. I'm gonna track her with the phone. We'll be shooting a wide angle, and then as she hits the sand, we'll transition to a pool shot where she falls into the pool, and we'll stitch them together on the Asus Pro Art afterwards. So we've now come to the pool to shoot the second half of the reel. And we're gonna get Kayla to stand on the edge of the pool and fall backwards into it. And we'll use that as the transition from the sand at the beach. And I'm gonna take the phone and put in the G-Dome, because it just makes it a lot easier to shoot underwater. And also because of the dome, we can just film the transition from above the water to below the water a lot easier, a lot more seamless. And we actually get to see the surface of the water a lot better, because the distance between the camera and the water is now separated by the G-Dome. So when editing in post-production, it just makes the masking a lot easier. So, okay, so once again, we're gonna jump back into Premiere and edit this. Now, it's a pretty simple edit with the two clips, just a bit of masking and keyframing, but when done properly, it has a really effective result. And here is the final edit. It's all I've given. So I think that pretty much wraps up this week's video. I hope you guys have enjoyed watching it and seeing a little bit of a behind the scenes onto how I create some short form content. A big thanks to Asus for sponsoring this week's video. It's been a lot of fun playing around on the Pro Art Studio Book. If you guys want to check out more about this machine, I will have it linked below. And yeah, go check it out. And I will see you guys in the next one. Yoop.